The day was ending, the soft red orb of the sun dropping into the mouth of the sea. It cast a veil of golden light over the waves, which swayed and danced to its touch. The mountains of the coast radiated gold. The dome of sky above me glowed pink, tangerine, and lilac. And then, from my heart, a sweet, commanding voice called, "Go to India." Why India? I thought. It's another world so far away. I know so little about it. I had next to no money and little idea of what to expect. But I believed that this was the voice of my Lord calling for me.
India, to me, is very dear. Someday, I promise, I will do good for your people. Give me one chance, I will help your people. The kind old soul considered my plea and granted permission much to my glee. Thump, my legal entry to India.
It was at the railway station in Varanasi that we squirmed into a train of compressed human bodies, crushed limb to limb in the sweltering heat of the monsoon. The whistle blew as the steam engine pumped up bellows of smoke and hissed out steam. The heavy steel wheels ground forward. The train lurched. And we were on our way. The monsoon storm was furious, converting an agricultural field into a muddy lake and paralyzing the engine. Hours passed in stagnancy. In the extreme heat, striving to set aside my physical discomfort, I longed to hear the whistle blow signaling movement. Nearly 2 days later, the train inched out of the fields and before dawn halted at an unknown station. Gary and I escaped through a window and onto the platform for temporary relief before the journey continued. I saw some sadhus sitting some distance ahead in a circle on the platform. I gestured to Gary to wait. And I approached them. "Excuse me," I inquired, "where are we?" Saying nothing, a sadhu stared up into my eyes as if he had been waiting for me. Rising to his feet, he broke the silence. "This is Mathura, Lord Krishna's birthplace, and today is Janmashtami, Krishna's birthday." On their invitation, Gary and I walked with them to the place where the Janmashtami festival was being celebrated.